Hi and welcome. My name is Lotte and this is Made of Yarn podcast. I'm coming from Sweden. I will talk about just knitting today, I guess. Yes. And yarns. So I said I come from Sweden. It's about in the middle of Sweden on the east coast. I was considering to sit outside, perhaps the last opportunity this year to sit outside before the winter comes, but it was still too cold. Well, I can dress. We can dress, can't we? We who are knitters. But it was easier for me today to do it here in my craft room. So I hope it's okay. And it's quiet, more quiet here also, because outside and it's Sunday and the neighbor kids love to play outside and you can hear them. And it's nice, but isn't it easier to listen when it's more quiet around you? You are so welcome. And both old and new ones. I will talk about the as usual what I'm wearing, where I'm knitting on, my plans, and so on and so on. So what am I wearing? Have you been here before? You have seen it also before. This is the Love Note by Tin Can Knits. Can't remember when I made it, a couple of years ago. It's in a sock yarn from the former dyer here in Sweden, Fru Valborg. She isn't dyeing anymore. Oh, sorry, hair in my eye. And I can't remember just the what's inside it. But I also, more than it, I know that it's really soft because it's not just an ordinary sock yarn. And also one thread from Holst Titicaca. The it's an alpaca yarn. So I can tell you I'm warm and it's cozy now. I made this one twice, not this one, I made Love Note two times. This one and also an orange one. I will show you a photo soon. But I don't know if you can see, but I choose to not make the whole chart out, the whole repetition of in the pattern, because for me then I have to have a tank top or something underneath. Now I just can have a sports bra. And I think it's nice. I think it's just 1.5 repetition, if I remember right. This one is slightly longer. The first one I made, was it the first one? I can't remember which one. One of the other one, it's an orange that I've actually just worn a couple of times. One time here, recording, showing you, and one time and another time, because that one was more cropped and I don't like it. It's not fitting my figure, so to say. Well, if I have a dress and I have it on top of that one, but I would like to use it more often than so. So about a week ago, we had here many from our family, my brothers, one of my brothers and his family and grandchildren and so on, and my kids and so on, because we had, I tried to search the word. In Swedish, it's we were eating surströmming. It's fermented herring. It's so yummy. It's so yummy. But if you heard it before, you know that it also stinks. But the taste is so good. So when my daughter Amanda and her husband should visit us, then they visited us last weekend, and she said, "Please, can we eat that?" Because in our area here, we live in the it's called the northern parts of Sweden. We are crazy about surströmming, this fermented herring. And so they were out of it in the stores here, in the grocery stores. But where Amanda and Oliver lives, it's more in the middle and of Sweden, more south. They don't eat it as much because they had so much in the store. So they bought for us, for my sister-in-law and my niece. so they also have, so we can perhaps eat later on in the winter. It's not the best dish to eat inside because, as I said, it smells. So this one, you it's best to eat it outside. But last winter we ate it in the basement of for my brother and sister-in-law, and it was so nice. What should I say? Well, I was talking about love note and talking about surströmming later on. Then it when the time the evening started to come, it was colder, so my brother's daughter-in-law Tette asked if I had something to for her to wear, and she is so sensitive. So first I gave her this one, and she said, oh, she really loved it, and she talked about the color. I wish I could have something like this, the color, but she said I had to have something else for my, I don't know in English, for the colors to pop more. And then I come to think, her boys, Edward and Fred, they are 8 and 11, they love orange, as I do. So I picked up the other one and thought perhaps she also likes it, and she did. So I said, you can, if you like it and think you will have a use for it, you can take it. And she was so happy for it. So I will put in a photo here. Here is Tete on with the love note, the more cropped one. On her, it was perfect, really. So it's a nice pattern, really, it is. Well, that was what I have on me. I have my notes here, a little bit too long. I have it on I don't know what it's called. Can you see it? For notes. Many years ago, I played a flute. Also piano, but then I don't have to have this one. I now and then play the flute also, but not as often as when I was younger. Oy. But it's perfect now to have my notes, my iPad on it. Now and then, I like to test knit. I did it much earlier years. This time it was for a Swedish designer, Anneli Verbrygge. She is Power of Wool, both on Instagram and on Ravelry. She will release now in 1st of October in another, not in Ravelry. Here in Sweden we have a, will you say company? I don't know. It's called Nordic Knitting Society. You can subscribe on their patterns, and they have also in English and in Danish. It's northern designers from the northern countries, Scandinavia, around here. And what should I say? You can subscribe on them, and you can just subscribe for 1 month and buy that pattern if you like. I forgot a little bit how it's described, but you can go in there and I will link it so you can check it out. There is so much. There have been, is it a couple of years now? So there is quite a lot of patterns. They have a monthly club, and it can be whatever in clothing. They have a sock club, and they have a seasoning club. A season club. You can check it out. So then, now then, in October, these mittens will come out. I started first to knit in the sizes is three sizes. So I picked the middle one, and it should be with 3.5 millimeter needles, and a DK weight yarn, kind of. So I started with the Norwegian wool Viking Eco Highland wool, I think it was that. But when I started, I recognized, I saw that it should be too small. So, So I thought about it and said, first, well, my probably to be daughter-in-law, she has very small hands. It would be nice for her. But when I continued, I thought, well, no, it's more for children. So then I thought about Fred, who is 8. So I will show them here. And also, I made some embroidery. I don't know if it's called that. Just if he lose them in the school, Fred. Then he got them the last weekend also. And he said, well, I can have them now. So he said he felt that they were a little bit too small. No, they were narrow. But he said, they will be good. And when you are outside and you have, we call it in Sweden, snowball war in the middle. You make snowballs and they throw them on each other. Then the mittens will get wet, and then they will grow also with movements. Anyway, before I knew that they were too small for him, I also said to myself that I guess Edward also need one. But you always need mittens because you lose almost every winter, many pairs disappeared when my children were small, or just came home with one. And myself also, when you sit in the car and are driving, you put the mittens in your lap, and then you go outside and you forgot that you had them in the lap, and you just walk away. Sometimes they are still there when you come back, but many times they are just gone with the wind. Well, I asked Edward what colors he liked, and he wanted something with orange. So I made this pair for him. He's 11, as I said before, but when he tried them on, he now has a grown-up hand, because he said also, well, I can have them. But then Fred tried them, and it was perfect on him. So I said, I will make you a new pair. So now Fred has two pairs, and Edward didn't have any other one, anyone at that time. But I made a new pair. I will show them soon. Before I made the new pair for Fred, I made another one here also, another pair. So they are looking like this. Oh, you have seen them in the photos. So I can also put in photos so you can see them better on this one. It's a fun knit. It goes so fast. You make one in almost one evening when it's thicker yarn. So what I made a difference here, I changed the yarn also on Edward's and this one. And Edward's, it's both from the company Järbo. So the Edward's was Järbo Alpe. It's 100% wool. And this is also 100% wool. It's their 3-plied svensk ull, Swedish wool. And then in this pair also I took, also in Edward's, 4 millimeters needles. So they are, for me, they are perfect now. Edward complained, he said the thumbs, probably I have a shorter thumb, I don't know, but for him they were too short. So I made him a new pair. So they were here on Friday, so I made one in on Saturday and one on Sunday. So he will get this one. I don't know how well you can see they are. So now for this pair I made size 3, so, and added some rows also on the thumb. So this one, or I can move my fingers, but it's such a nice pattern, really. I love it. She also has, and that she has own Ravelry, or is it, are they own on Ravelry? Anneli socks in this. These are called Crofters. Have I wrote it down? Crofters mittens. And she also have socks, Crofters socks. Also made in the same way. And I have bought the pattern. I haven't made them yet. But the people who have knitted them, they said they are not making just one pair, they are continuing to, because it's a fun pattern. Sorry, I just had to have a water break. And just see here what I talked about here. I also made another test knit, but I can't show them. For this company we have here in Sweden, Edna, they have the main the Swedish brands they have. It's Järbo yarn from Järbo and Svarta Fåret. But they many times a year they come with new collections. And I don't know when this sock will be released. I forgot about to talk about that. Hello, ask her. But the designer is, her name is Ellen Förderer, yes. And her name on Ravelry and Instagram is Hurly Pearly Knits. And you can check her out because she has much free patterns. And also, you can check out Edna dot whatever, wherever you live. I guess you have .com, we have .se, .dk, .de, and you have, they have patterns in many languages, and they are all free, so it's so much fun. Well, I will show that sock when it will be released, but I can tell you that my daughter Louisa loves them and wear them all the time. I forgot about when my daughter Amanda then and her husband came last weekend. She asked before, can you please, if I could knit her a sock with thicker yarns and cables,
of course.
I saw a pattern on the Finnish company Novitas site, and they have also, most of their patterns are free, not the newest ones, but they, after a time, when they, because they have magazines, and when the newer magazines come, they release the other ones, the older ones, as free. But they have a sock, so I can show you here. It calls Pause or Pause, and it's knitted in the thicker sock yarn, Novita Isoveli, in the color Linen. I love the color. So I made it, and it was knitted in 5 millimeter needles, so you can also see, understand that they were a quick knit also. So she got them the last weekend, and her husband Oliver I talked about him before. He's one of the most knit-worthy persons I have ever met. And of course, he also had to have a pair of socks. So I took the leftovers from Amanda's socks, and I have one ball of yarn from before in the same this Isovelli. I made him a sweater earlier this year in a Bourgogne or something like that color. You can see them here. It's not, I just made them up with stripes. And he put them on directly, and then afterwards they went fishing. So he was so warm and toasty on his feet. He loved them. I will make him more socks also. And both of them, they love socks. Oh, I have to say, my husband, I talked about him before. He can't stand wool. You say wool and he almost, he's afraid of it. But I talked a couple of days ago, he's not longing for winter, if you can say it like that, because one of his main work is, he's in the cleaning business, and he say when you go inside and out and you swipe stairs and so on, and you go outside and you are in snow piles, and then you go inside and you are always wet on the feet. And I say, think if I could, and then also cold, of course, think if I could make you wear the socks that I made you before. But because I said, do you not remember when we were children, we have a pattern here in Sweden called Lovika mittens, Lovika vantar. They are made in very thick yarn, and it's from it's in a village far north in Sweden called Lovika. It was, I can't remember the details, but a woman there who made this, and they are called them. Everyone in Sweden knows Lovika vantar. And we had them when we were small. And we said, when we had this snowball war, or just made igloos or snowballs, and we made them... like this, or in the round, and then put a candle inside. It's beautiful in the evening. Well, after a while, when it was plus degrees, because when it's about 0 Celsius and a plus, then you can make the snowballs. But the mittens became wet. But you were always warm, even though you were wet on the hands, you were warm. And I said, that's wool. So even if you are wet on the feet, you will be warm. So he said, well, perhaps I will try that this year. I have a war with him every winter. I try to remember him. He once said, well, it's quite warm to have them. But then when the next winter comes, yeah, he has forgotten about it. Well, I will see. The snow isn't here yet, but I will make him thinner ones, but because I made him more in a DK weight. But it's easier for him than if I make this with in fingering, just so he thinks that it's an ordinary sock. I will just make notes that I talked about it. I will dive. I made, now I make a pause. I forgot also, as usual, to talk about that on Ravelry I am Lotte Blom, and on Instagram I am Hjort av Garn. I'm sorry, I've talked almost 25 minutes and now it come. And I also have this in Swedish, so that's if you have wondering if you are coming back why I didn't. Usually I will put them out on YouTube both in the same time, but it was a week ago that I made the Swedish one. So perhaps I will think to do it like this, to perhaps I'm more clear in my head than make it in a row. Anyway, when I showed it in this Swedish podcast, the last one, it wasn't finished. I will see if you can see it. This, and it was like this. My daughter is sleeping over Louisa here, and she had it in. I found it. She left it down here because she is using it all the time now. It's a sweater that the pattern is actually a dress. I will see here, so you perhaps can see. It's not blocked even. She worn it directly. I saw. I'm sorry. I can't show it. I will see here if I can. It's from this book, from Sandnes, and it's called Hazel Dress. But as I said, I just made it as a sweater. I don't know if you can see it there. Perhaps it's better here. I showed it, I think I showed it also last time. Because you have seen a photo on somewhere on the internet on a pink sweater with a balloony arms and a cozy one like this. So, and this is actually all over acrylic yarn because she is quite sensitive to wool. So we can try this, how it will be if I see already that it starts to, I don't know the word in English, but I can depill it after a while if it's needed. It's from a Danish company, but they are here in Sweden also now. Mayflower, I think. Can it be also Mayflower.com? They have much nice, both free patterns, but much nice yarns and so much sales all the time. So that was a finished object actually, and I'm thirsty again, sorry. Another one that I've been working on, I've had to dive again, it's fall down here. I've been working on this since middle of the summer, something, because we have one of the bigger designers here in Sweden. Oh, I forgot to show the book. Sofia Karlsson. This is just for the moment in Swedish. It calls Knitting a Warming Love Story. Sofia Karlsson is the former, her former name here on YouTube, because she has a YouTube channel. Now it's Sofia's Tales, but it's former Camibornia, if you know her more from that. But she made her first book. I have test knitted quite a lot for her over the years. Socks, mittens, half mittens, hats and so on. But now she also started to make cardigans and sweaters. So I ordered this book, but before that, I forgot to say, when I saw her making sneak peeks on Instagram this summer, I said, the eyes, whoop, this one is so beautiful. And she said, you can have the pattern for this one. So I started directly. In my head, also, if you have been here before, you know that I love to now and then doing natural dyes with whatever I can find out in the nature or before I throw things in the compost. So I will show you here. I had one thread here. This one is, I have no idea what it is in English actually. Just one undyed. I can do like this. I'm showing you what I have done so far instead, because I know this one is another one than the other skein, and because I have it here, and it's sun. Do you say sun dyed? Cold brewed coffee. this one. Many colors get almost the same. Now, throw it again on the floor. Like coffee, tea, at least for me, avocado, and this other one that I can't remember. Also, acorns were about the same. So I had a lot of this. I made some blankets and so, but I always wanted something to wear with what I've done. I will do like this so perhaps can see. You have this is roses, but I don't really know if you can see them good enough. I was hesitating to take this yellow. I think it's birch. What did I say before? Sun dyed? I think it's another word. Where is it? Sun dyed? I have them in jars outside. Well, birch anyway. Because there is yellow roses in the in real life also. Well, I can see them here because the contrast isn't that good. So perhaps I said, perhaps I will make some duplicate stitches if it's too much, if you can't see them. Or not. The leaves, or whatever you can say it is, the arrows, that's reed. Reed, yeah, reed. So I made now the whole body. And then, no, just the sleeves. So I will continue with that later, perhaps today. Here I can see. It doesn't matter if it's, because it's natural dye. So for me, if there is another nuance or so, it doesn't matter for me. So that was a gift from her, the pattern, but then I bought the book. Just checking here. We're talking about natural dye. I should show you a skein, but I can't find it. I have another. Or is it this one? Perhaps it is. Now I forget. If I remember, I will put in the right word for the flower here. I visited my nephew David, he and his wife is our neighbors, and they thrown away this in Swedish tagetes. They should throw them on the compost. I thought, oh, perhaps I haven't dyed in a while. So I thought perhaps I will over dye because I had this. Sorry, I think I had about this. It was too light yellow, and I think, what will I make with this? I don't know. So I tried to over dye it. So it was looked like this before, about, and then, so you can see it's striped, or not striped, but it took different whenever, I don't know the right words, but you can see it's not just a solid color. And then I thought also, well, I have so much these who look the same. So I took, but I don't think it's this one, is it? I have to check, sorry. I think this is a 3-plied. It's not exactly the same, but it's almost. So this one, I over-dyed it. I love the color. It was because I went back to them because they went to Germany and I should water the flowers. And I checked if they still have these flowers because I thought when they come home, they are already over and done with. So I took them and I thought if some other neighbor have more of this, and I forgot, oh, well, I have them myself, but I didn't have that much. So because when I started to boil them, I saw that it was too little color to make it an over dye. So I digged in I digged somewhere, can't remember the word again, and found a paper bag with onion skins. We call them yellow onions and also red onions. I had just had a few of red onion, but I had to cut actually because I couldn't talk. So it's both these tagetes, whatever they are called, and red and yellow onion skins, over dyed. I can't remember the first one. Perhaps it was an avocado, but I love it. Really, really nice. So a couple of dyes also since the last time. I got this summer. Sorry. A friend of mine asked. She came with just socks, this part of the sock. She had cut off the feet because they were too worn out. So she asked, she said, this part is so good. So can you just make them whole again and make them a feet? 2 feet, of course, I said. So I made, I can put in a photo. They are not beautiful. I understood by the feeling the fabric that it was just not any superwash in the yarn because they have been like felted. So I had the first pair that you saw was slightly blue because I couldn't see it with my eye, but in a photo they were like this. But it doesn't matter, for Katarina is her name. So I tried first with 2 plies from Unspun yarn. We have one here not far from us called Filtmakeriet, but it's like Nutiden or something like that. So I took 2 plies, but it was a little bit too thin compared to the leg part. So then I took 3 threads together. So now she will be warm and cozy this winter. But it's good to do like this because you should faint if you saw many of my socks because I wear them so they get holes quite easy. And I mend them and I mend them and I mend them. Sometimes before, I sadly throw away a lot of them. And it has been wiser and smarter to just cut off the leg part and make a new one, because many of them I made, they were quite beautiful, but because I've test knitted lots of socks also during the years for example, Tracy Miller, for Sari Nordlund, many more. I can't, now it's stopped in my head. With delicate patterns, it could be cables or lace and so on, and just throw away these beauties are sad. That's why I mostly, for myself at least, I knit with cheaper yarns. I don't know if you see, I have a collection of sock yarns here, but It almost hurt, and here I got gifts also. It's almost hurtful to have them on the feet when I know that they are breaking soon. I have a plan to use many of these skeins, hanks, to make a sweater. instead. Also, I have a lot. It's a buy now and then, and also perhaps a shawl and so on. And talking about socks again, and you saw me showing a sock here. This one I couldn't show for the Swedish viewers because I hadn't started it yet. My plan is this year, you heard it before, is to make 12 pairs of socks from Tracy Miller's patterns, because I just love her socks. I've test knitted almost every one of them. I've test knitted for her since the beginning. And when I now have so much patterns, why not use them again? Because many of them are worn out and gifted. So this one is the Galliano socks. I wonder if that, I'm not sure if that's her first pattern. Oh, I got the fluff in my nose. Oh, sorry. This is one, oh, fly. A new from the company Järbo, a new color way. Yeah, you can see it here. It's striped in more pastelic colors, more muted ones. But I took also one fluff yarn in. It's Drops Kid Silk. But I'm still using the same pattern and also 2.5 millimeter needles that the pattern says. But when I know, because I now have through two threads, that it will be more well dense but bigger because of that. So I make it just the smallest size, and that will be perfect. It looks very narrow, but it's really good because it's you can stretch it out also when you are blocking it. But it's, I can see the pattern, of course. But it's good to have a sock that are smaller than your foot are, because they will sit snug and not get slippery in the shoe. So this is so much better for my feet, at least. So this is the number 9 for this year, and it's perfect because it is September. So I have just after this pair, this is the first one, I just made almost one, I just have then 3 to make. And October, what is that? Socktober. So I guess I will make socks also, as many others. I forgot about, again, talking about this company, Edna here in Sweden. They have many of their collections, when they come out, they are gifting many of us who have podcasts yarn. The patterns are free for everyone, but also yarn to make something. But they don't say you have to make, talk about it. They say if you like, you can make it. So I got from their newest collection, you can see here, it's called, the pattern is called, I don't know how to pronounce it, Mercia. Because they have a new, they started, this is for Svarta Fåret. So they have now started with brushed alpaca. So this is another yellow than in the pattern, because it's for my daughter Lovisa. And she wanted these more autumn, fall colors. And I started to make it directly, but I have to rip it up, because now I have it on another cable needle, and you can see. It's way too big, because you start, you make a border here first with 4.5 millimeter needle. Then you make, you increase the double amount, knit a part here with 6 millimeter needle, then you decrease half of it again and make a in for 4.5 millimeter needles, and you continue to do that. But it's not easy then, for me at least, to check the gauge. So this is enormous. So I had to rip it back and think. I had to think what size, because I started to make. First, my thought was in the. What did I call this? Well, I thought it's from the bottom up, down and up. I started to make the biggest size for my daughter, because she likes when they are more boxy. But I understood that I think I can go down a size. So the rest is just 1XL. And you can see that this looks like, I don't know what. Is too big. So perhaps I even can make them in medium if I have this gauge. So it will be my next project to finish this bag, because she really loves long to wear it. Oh, I have to. Did you hear my knee? I'm so sorry, I don't know why I'm so thirsty. We have a podcaster here in Sweden, her name is Anna, but she always has it in Swedish, Stor Härvan. But she said a thing, I can say it also here, the importance to for us who are watching other podcasts to show our appreciation for them, because I didn't really understand it myself before I started podcasting. I saw, yeah, well, you can make this thumbs up and you can make a comment, but I think I just made it when it was like a giveaway or something, because I didn't really understand why. I didn't understand that when you give this thumbs up, the person who have this podcast gets so happy for it. And when you make also a comment and also subscribe, you are making our day. We are making each other's days. and she said also, talked about it because she compared to Norway. And when I talked about this also in this Swedish episode, for those of you who are for us abroad in Canada or America or England or wherever you live, you can see many make comments and the thumbs up. And that also makes us, the person who have the podcast are seen also from YouTube. So what I'm trying to say, can we make an experiment? If you like this episode or my episodes overall, please push the thumbs up button. And if you like, you can also make a comment, because that makes so much difference for us to be seen. We are so many podcasters, and when you come from Scandinavia, I've said it before, it's not easy to be seen out in the world. So I would be so happy if you could make that. And if you don't know where you're looking now, you can see, I don't know if you're watching in a phone or a tablet or on the computer, wherever, but you can always see a thumb and you hit that button there. And also you have subscribe, so you're also welcome to do it. And it will be interesting to see if that makes a difference for this episode. Next month, I will see when I will record them, because I will make something in Swedish. I talked about it last episode also with other Swedish podcasters, a 24 hours knit along, and some of us will have podcasts, or she will make something. She is Mary Lou Knitting on both YouTube and Instagram. That's she, Marie Louise. She will make also groups on Google Meet. I'm not that, I don't really know how it works, but she will do it. And so people will sit in groups and knit together and talk together. And then also some of us will have in Swedish then on YouTube. I have no idea what I will talk about. I made that before in English 3 or 4 times, I can't remember, for Pietrans Traveling Miss Knits, is she now? She has this knit-a-thon, and that will be in November this year. I can't remember really the name, but if you go into Pietrans home page, it's 50fabulousknits.dk, I think. And on her Instagram account also, she will talk about it more, and you can see the plans. I had to cut again because I couldn't speak. You can check out Pietrans homepage or Instagram, and then you can see what her plans are for that in November. That's so fun. That's one of the she has in spring and in autumn, and it's the highlights of the year to do this. It's so much fun. So if you haven't participated in that, do that. It's so much fun, and you can see things afterwards also. I think I told you before also, they are still, because when you make them live, they are, when you're checking this, my page here on YouTube, you can see that there is lives. You can read live. I can't explain. But you can see older podcasts that I made live there on Knitathon. If you're still here, I'm so grateful. it's what it is when you come in. I'm just doing a last check up, and I think I talked about everything. Yes, I did. Because I haven't made notes on the Galliano sock, but I talked about them. I talked almost an hour. I thought I didn't have so much to say, so perhaps 20 minutes. So I'm grateful that you visited me, that you are coming back. And if you're a new one, thank you. I hope you will come back also. So let's see what I will talk about the next episode. I wish you, wherever you live, I know at least one of you lives in South Africa. So you are going towards summer now, lucky you. And we are going towards winter. But I took in some of our last sunflowers to enjoy. But soon for us here in the Northern Hemisphere, it's going towards sweater and cardigan seasons. So we are going to be warm and cozy the whole winter. But it's still just autumn. It just started. So we have hopeful, but what date is in about 3 weeks, we can have snow here in my area. I read in some northern of Sweden, it started to snow already. And I continue to talk. I'm so sorry. Let me loosen. I talk I can talk 24/7. Thank you for your patience and that you're visiting me, and welcome back. Have a nice time. Bye.